Good morning to all of you. This is our part 2 video of chapter 7, which is diversity in living organism. If you remember what we have seen in our first video, in that video we have seen what the kingdom planted. A kingdom planted is in the 5 divisions. This 5 division was having different level of differentiation in their tissue level or organs level. In the same way, in this video, we are going to see the fifth kingdom, which is animal. Okay, or you can also say animal. So, in the animal, we are again going to see the different level of the divisions in the tissue level, organ level, and other type of the things. Now, if we start the animal, in animal, we are going to see the cellular level organisms. Organisms which are not having tissues in their body, which are only made up of the cells. वो मल्टीसेलुलर होते हैं लेकिन सिर्फ सेल्स से बने होते हैं, टिश्यूज अवेलेबल नहीं होते. तो दिस काइंड ऑफ द एनिमल्स आर नोन एज पॉलीफेरा. नाउ दिस वर्ड पॉलीफेरा मींस द होल्स. सो द पॉलीफेरा ऑर्गेनिज्म का प्रीडोमिनेंटली एक्वाटिक, जो ज्यादातर पानी में रहते हैं. अनदर थिंग, द बॉडी इज कंप्लीटली मेड अप ऑफ होल्स एंड पोर्स. छोटे छोटे होल्स रहते हैं इन फ्रॉम विच वॉटर गेट ट्रांसपोर्टेड एंड ऑल्सो ऑक्सीजन गेट ट्रांसपोर्टेड. The outer skin is something harder, like a skeleton. And the example for the polyphora will be the sponge. Water के अंदर जो sponge होते हैं, mostly वो example रहते हैं polyphora के. So this is the first level of the classification for the animal, and the cellular level polyphora is there. If we move on to the second level of the classification, you can see that from here we can see the tissue levels. So whatever we are going to see from here, we are going to have the differentiation till the tissue level. Now यहाँ पे सबको tissue आना start हो गए. In tissue level the basic with the no cavity. Now what do you mean by this word cavity? Cavity means hollow space. Like I have a hollow space in my mouth. I am having hollow space in my gut. All of this hollow space मतलब खाली जगह जो होती है उसको हम cavity बोलते हैं. So there is no true cavity or proper cavity in this kind of organism. The first organism in which is colon tetra. Now colon tetra you can say is a little bit more complex compared to the polyphera. The main reason that these are the complex because they are having two layers of the skin, outer and inner. So just two layers are the skin ki. So ek bahar ki layer hoti hai, ek andar ki layer hoti hai. Because of which they are considered as a little bit more complex compared to the polyphera, which we have seen earlier. Another thing to note about colon tetra is that they live in the colonies. वो साथ में colony बनाने रहते हैं like in humans. Now if we move on the next division for the no cavity organism, our Plethyhelminthes. Our Plethyhelminthes is much more complex compared to the colon tetra, which are in the same, you can say tissue level differentiation. After tissue level differentiation also Plethyhelminthes is much more complex. The reason they are much more complex are there. Now they are having three layers of skin, other tissues. They are having three layers. Therefore, they are also known as triploblastic. The first layer is used for outer skin, second layer for the inner skin, and third for the making of organs or the tissues inside that. So they are the three layers. Therefore, they are also known as triploblastic. They are again bilaterally symmetrical. Bilaterally. Symmetrical. Now, what do you mean by bilaterally symmetrical? For an example, as a human, I am also bilaterally symmetrical. If someone cuts me from the center, अगर मैं बीच में से खुद को काट दूँ, then my left and the right body will look similar. दोनों body parts में left side एक हाथ होगा, right side एक हाथ, left में एक हाथ होगी, right में एक हाथ होगी. In this way, my half of the body looks exactly similar to my other half of the body. If I am going to cut it from the center. This thing means a bilaterally symmetrical. So Plethyhelminthes are the bilaterally symmetrical organism. So we have learned two new words over here: triploblastic and as well as bilaterally symmetrical. Another thing to note about Plethyhelminthes, they are dorsoventrically flat down. मतलब जो dorsoventrically जो उनकी skin होती है बिल्कुल flat होती है, like this, like you can say serrated like structure. So they are having very flat body. बहुत फ्लैट बॉडी होती है इन द Plethyhelminthes. नाउ लेट अस मूव ऑन द नेक्स्ट टिश्यू लेवल में. जो नेक्स्ट आता है व्हिच इज सुडोकोलम. मतलब ओरिजिनल होलो स्पेस नहीं होती है, बट दे आर ट्राइंग टू मेक इन होलो स्पेस इन देयर बॉडी फॉर द ऑर्गन्स. सो द ओनली
division in the pseudocolon is nematoda. Nematoda is mostly symmetrical like platyhelminthes. They are also macroplastic. They are also having bilateral symmetrical body. The thing to note over here is now they are having cylindrical body instead of flat body. फिर हमको क्या है कि cylindrical body instead of the flat body. Because of cylindrical body, they are having much more space present in them compared to the platyhelminthes. Because of more space present in them, they can have a much more complex level of the differentiation inside them. Because of this, they are having the next level of the the differentiation. Therefore, we kept this division into pseudocolon differentiation level. Now, let us move on the next or the last topic for today's video, that is columnate. Now, this columnate is then you can say the true cavity, true hollow space. So, for the hollow space, we learned two words today. One is cavity and other word is column. So, columnate means the animals which are having true cavity inside their body. So, the first organism for the true cavity is an annelida. Annelida is an organism which are having a true body cavity or true space inside them. Because of that true space, they are having space for fitting the organs. A body can space the organs. So, because they have a properly hollow space available, so annelida can the organs are like reproductive organs, digestive organs, and etc. etc. Another thing to note, the annelida are the segmented. They are segmented in their body. Now, what do you mean by the segmented? If I draw something like this, now suppose earthworm is a structure, they are having segments in their body, like this. It's segments in this body. So, properly body segmented okay, from the head to the tail. Because of this kind of segments present in their body, they can fit the organs in a particular way. Like for this, they can say in my fourth segment, reproductive organs are there. In my sixth segments, I am having digestive organ. In this way, they are having the proper segments in their body, and according to that, they are able to fit all the things properly inside their body. They are complex compared to nematoda because nematoda was having the pseudo cavity or the pseudo column, and they are having the proper cavity. Now, next group present in the true cavity is a mollusca. Now, if I talk about the mollusca, mollusca is also having the true body cavity. They are having the hand-like structure or the foot-like structure to go from one place to another place very easily. After that, mollusca is having the open circulatory system. What do you mean by open circulatory system? Like in humans, if I talk about the humans, hum insaan ka closed circulatory system hota hai. Hamare body ke andar veins hoti hai, arteries hoti hai, blood vessels hoti hai, jiske andar se blood travel karta hai. But they are not having the proper kind of blood vessels for the blood to travel. They are having the open circulatory system because of which their complete cavity is filled with their blood. The thing to note, mollusca are the first which are having kidney-like organ. Mollusca are the first which are having the kidney-like organ for their excretion, for the removing of the waste material. Now, the last group for the true cavity is the arthropoda. Now, arthropoda is arguably the largest division in the animal life. In arthropoda, they are having the true body cavity, same as the mollusca or the annelida. They are having the open blood circulatory system, like mollusca means their complete body is filled with the blood. And same which you have seen in the earlier things, they are macroplastic, they are bilaterally symmetrical. But this orthopoda means jointed legs. Only the legs are jointed. This is a major division because most of the insects are going to come into the orthopoda. Like spiders are going to come into the orthopoda. All of these kind of things which you see at your home, insect like things are mostly going to come into the orthopoda. Therefore, we are saying that orthopoda is arguably the largest group present in the animal. So here, how many groups do you see? How many divisions do you see? If we count them, the very first division which you see is the porifera. in which only holes were there, nothing was present in them. After this, the second which we have seen was the pollen tetra, in which we have seen the two skin layers, two layers in which they are having differentiation. Then we have seen the plethyanthesis, in which we have seen the many newtons like microplastic, bilaterally symmetrical, and they are dorsometrically flatter. So these are the main properties for them. This was the third group. And fourth, which we have seen nematoda, they were having a similar structure like plethyanthesis. The main difference was that they are cylindrical in shape now. Because of cylindrical in shape, they are having more space like pseudo cavity present in them. After the end of the two cavity, we were seeing the anaridia first. And anaridia, we have seen the segmented body. And the segmented body, they can fit the organs very properly in a proper arranging way. After that, we have seen mollusca. Mollusca were having the feet like structure to work properly or to move from one place to another place. Another thing to note that mollusca was having a kidney like structure for their excretion. After that, we have seen the arthropoda, which was arguably the largest group for the animal kingdom. And arthropoda is having the jointed legs, open circulatory system in which blood is completely filled. So, this was the thing for our today's video. We are going to continue animal after the orthopoda in our next video. Yes, animal is still there. We are not having this much only division. Animal is काफी बड़ा है compared to plant. से plant में हमने सिर्फ पांच ही देखे थे, पर animal is काफी बड़ा है. We will see it in the next video. And we are going to continue after the orthopoda. I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. If you are having any doubt regarding this video, you can ask me in our live sessions. And I am going to send you a PDF or a worksheet regarding this video, which was supposed to write in your class notebooks.